experience with how to manage people, how to manage all the communication skills, government, banking, numerology, worldwide. Doesn't matter what your language is, all world leaders belong to the Masonic Order, and they act together.
Surprise announcement from the Oval Office of a peace deal between Bahrain and Israel.
President Trump announced it just weeks after the United Arab Emirates took the same step.
Some praise it for promoting peace, and others call it electioneering for Trump and Netanyahu.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the latest attacks on food production by some evil governors who need to be removed from office promptly, to the UK announcing that they will use the army to help secure grocery stores and enforce mask wearing, to sitting members of US Congress warning that we are about to experience food shortages.
None of the lending facilities established have targeted the needs of our agriculture industry. Now, why do I mention that? Food. It's coming. I mean, I can't see why people can't see this crisis. Food shortages are coming. It's almost like the farmers have been the forgotten ones. All the food chain is going down. You hear about the closures. The food processors are going out. Farmers are coming. These are small, most of them, but they're very important. Why can't they be qualified as small businesses? Where are they? They're getting lost in the shuffle. And if we get a food shortage, we're in,
Yes, only they're not forgotten, are they? In fact, they are explicitly targeted, farmers, ranchers, as something that we need to eliminate, as described by the Rockefeller Foundation's Reset the Table plan. This document, part of the Great Reset that we're all experiencing, enjoying right now, describes the intention of eliminating farming and ranching as you and I have known it and replacing it with these synthetic lab-grown meat, insect protein, indoor farms. It's pretty ridiculous and dystopic, but they have agents in positions of power executing on that agenda right now, one of whom is Governor Inslee in Washington, who took it to a whole new level this past week. Instead of just shutting down farming, he literally committed an act of agricultural terrorism by taking apples from the governor's mansion to East Washington, the actually productive areas of his state, for which he holds nothing but utter contempt. Perhaps because they're more conservative. These apples that he brought with them to make people feel better. Look at this political stunt. Mask on, baskets of bioweapons in hand that he passed out. Now the Washington Agricultural Division is actively trying to get these apples back because they were infected with apple fly maggots that could... I mean, he took them out of a quarantine area into the most productive agricultural land in his state and risks all of the apple orchards there. So just really kind of blatant and iconic. It's quite representative of the attacks that they're committing at all levels. But let's look at the legislative level. Here in California, Governor Newsom signed a pair of bills this past week, which accomplishes two things chiefly. First, it expands the testing for COVID-19 that is available to farm workers. The tests that, as you and I now know, have a 90% false positive rate, but notwithstanding that, if anyone tests positive, even if it's totally fake, now farms and other employers are being required by law to disclose these fallacious test results to everyone else that works on the farm or in any workplace. Of course, this will have the effect of shutting down farms, the intended effect, I should say. We've already seen this happen, farm workers going on strike after they learned via TV reports that some of their colleagues had coronavirus. So in doing this, he's forcing more tests out there to get more false positives, and then forcing the farms to tell everyone else about these false positives, which will shut down the farms. I hope that's very clear. And of course, we saw the same thing happening in Michigan, where Governor Whitmer requires now testing for farm workers, and so they're just leaving. And we read here, dozens of farm workers leaving unpicked fields and orchards behind. They're shutting down the food production. So that's what's going on, and that's why time and time again we see that somehow, while Amazon and Walmart are just fine, Black Lives Matter rallies, not a problem, but farms, food production, meat plants. Somehow these are always the hotspots. Look at this, the country's most productive farmland, now one of the worst COVID-19 hotspots. Yakima County, the West Coast's COVID-19 hotspot. Almost depends where you are. They'll just point at the farms and say that's it right there. Well, if you're in Maryland, that's those poultry plants, coronavirus hotspots. If you're in New York, it's those greenhouses, hotspot for coronavirus. Michigan, all the COVID-19 tests, cases come from the farms. You see, it doesn't really matter where you are. It's where the food is coming from, and that's where the hotspot is. And it's working. Ladies and gentlemen, farmers are feeling the effects. They need their labor right now most when it's harvest season. Sugar beets are one example here that were described. It's all about timing. You have only a few days to harvest all of those sugar beets and get them stacked. And here's another case, $100,000 of lettuce destroyed. This is in Australia, where the same sort of a tale is playing out. Perth farmer had to plow through 100,000 lettuces into the ground because he had no workers to harvest it. See, this isn't just noise that I'm making. This is actually happening, and food is actually getting destroyed right now. We always hear, oh, there's so much food in America or wherever, you'll never go hungry. That may be true. We have tons of production. But if we can't even harvest the food, we have real problems. And we'll see if they're bracing for food shortages. So this is very sad. And it goes on to say that the same thing will happen to his cauliflower, broccoli, celery, and spinach very soon as well. And so now we look to the UK, where the latest, Bojo is out there putting new lockdown procedures into place. There have been also these reports in the media about panic buying. And I mentioned this on Twitter, where I often float a lot of intel to see what kind of response we get. And what I heard in this case was, there was no panic buying going on. I heard from people in England and Scotland. They said this is completely made up. But nonetheless, the media has continued to push this story this week. And then as a response to this fake problem reaction solution, they've rolled out again rationing. So now Morrison's has started rationing. The items they mention in this article are toilet paper. It's not food, basically. It's just bleach and toilet paper. But if you go check it out on Twitter, they actually talk about canned foods and some other food items that are now being rationed as well. There's also one key critical piece down here at the bottom. Asda also said on Wednesday it is introducing 1,000 safety marshals at stores to reinforce the face masks and social distancing for shoppers. And as I mentioned, and as was covered here in the Telegraph, to help enforce these new safety measures, England will be deploying the army. It will be on hand to support the police to close down businesses that fail to force shoppers to wear their face masks. So suddenly, this gives a lot more credence to this pattern of armed guards at grocery stores and at farmers' markets, this militarization of the food supply. And while we saw a lot of coverage of this in the United States back in March, when the initial food rationing and this big hubbub was going down, if you actually look into it, this has continued. August 28th, why do you have armed security guards in your store? Why are you militarizing grocery shopping? Exactly. That's what's going on. Here's another one. Sam's Club now has armed security guards at the entrance. Why? Well, the story is to enforce masks, to enforce social distancing. But clearly, they're establishing armed police presence at points of food distribution. Here's another. My neighborhood grocery store now has an armed guard. My grocery store just got an armed guard for the first time. There goes the neighborhood. And you're supposed to avoid eye contact. Only make one run through the store. It helps now that the store has an armed guard to ensure compliance with the COVID-19 restrictions. And I covered in a previous report that there were now police kettling people, pushing them around, basically, at a market in Australia. And I got a lot of people, I got a lot of heat from people who were saying, Christian, this is nonsense. The police are only there to enforce social distancing and to make sure people are wearing masks. Ladies and gentlemen, I cannot help you if you are still buying into the idea that this is all for your safety. If you think that, I mean, look, they're pushing people into a single concentrated blob. That doesn't have anything to do with social distancing. And even more concerningly, the reports have continued to come out. Here is one video that came out of a French farmer's market where the police just came on the scene and then started shooting tear gas. This doesn't make any sense whatsoever. And so I posted it to my backup channel, Ice Age Farmer Resources, and asked the question, what is going on here? And nobody has a good answer, except this actually did happen. It's pretty concerning out there, ladies and gentlemen. We all need to be growing our own food right now and preparing for the food shortages that they have planned in the very near future. Let's go grow beautiful, abundant, nutritive food, raise awesome animals in holistic, healthy ways, and build great things. Be well.